Assalamu alaikum. As I mentioned earlier, my name is Ibrahim Hooper. I'm National Communications Director with the Council on American Islamic Relations. We're out here in Bristow, Virginia, outside a facility that the government has indicated may house children and infants who had been separated from their families.
Oops. Buenas tardes, estamos aquí con la organización de las consulado de relaciones islámicas. Este es Ibrahim Hooper y estamos en frente de la departamento donde supuestamente el gobierno ha dicho que ha puesto niños que han sido separados de su familia en el border.
Now, we communicated with this facility this morning as soon as we heard that there may be children and infants here, and they directed us to the HHS media department. We contacted the HHS media department and got no response. And a little later, Robert McCarr, government affairs director, will give an update on what they're telling us now about this facility.
Esta mañana, después de haber recibido noticia del gobierno de que hay una posibilidad de que hayan niños que han sido separados de su familia en esta facilidad, nosotros contactamos a la organización y no nos dieron respuesta. Dijeron que no podían confirmar o negar la alegación y no han dado ninguna respuesta al tema, y entonces no hay transparencia en el problema.
And just as a bit of information, we do have a representative here from Senator Warner's office.
Y por información, hoy tenemos un representante de la oficina de el senador Warner.
And so first we'll hear a few words from CARE's National Executive Director, Nehad Awad.
Primero vamos a oír unas palabras de el representante de CARE, Nehad Awad.
Awad, yes.
Awad.
Okay, can you hold this?
Sure.
And if you can do everything.
Hello everyone, I am Nehad Awad, N-I-H-A-D-A-W-A-D, the National Executive Director of CARE, the Council on American Islamic Relations. So we're here today in front of the Youth for Tomorrow's Center, who we believe are holding people against their will. The government has disclosed that there are immigrant children, possibly with their parents or without parents, are being held in this facility. We believe it is...
Let her do that.
Hoy estoy aquí con el ejecutivo de la organización CARE Nacional y estamos enfrente de la organización que se llama Youth for Tomorrow. Esta organización ha sido mencionada que puede tener niños que han sido separados de su familia o de sus padres y están aquí y no hemos recibido respuesta.
It is shocking for us that the Trump administration is using non-profit organizations and facilities like this that are designed for youth development to use them as detention centers for people against their will, whether children without parents or families who have been arrested at the borders.
Es una sorpresa horrible para nosotros saber que la administración de Trump está usando a organizaciones sin fondos lucrativos para detener y sostener a niños que están separados de su familia.
We have a very simple request and demand from the Trump administration today, which is to end the inhumane practice and policy of separating children from their parents, from their mothers and fathers who were detained at the border in facilities like this nationwide.
Tenemos una simple demanda al gobierno que sea transparente, que no esté deteniendo a niños y separando de su familia, porque es un acto inhumano.
We know that President Trump has signed an executive order yesterday only after pressure, only after he deceived the public by saying it was the responsibility of Congress, but not his own responsibility.
Estamos advertidos de que Trump firmó una orden ejecutiva reciente, pero eso vino solo después de demandas del público. Entonces esa demanda necesita seguir porque no hay todavía transparencia de dónde están los niños y los papás también andan buscándolos.
We believe that all Americans should continue to be pressuring this administration to end this inhumane practice, not only on paper through executive orders, but in practice by reuniting and reunifying children with their parents who have been arrested at the border once and for all.
Nosotros creemos que esta administración no necesita solo realizar una orden ejecutiva, necesitamos mirarlo en práctica también, la reunificación de las familias y los hijos que han sido separados.
This is not a political issue, and President Trump should not blackmail Congress to change this policy in exchange for building a wall that we believe it will not serve our national security or immigration policies, period.
Esta política del gobierno no debiera de ser, no es política, es inhumano, es una violación de derechos humanos de separar a familias, y el presidente no debiera usar al Congreso para poder agarrar la parte del trato que él desea.
So my final appeal is for all Americans, you should keep the pressure, contact your members of Congress, your legislators nationwide, keep the pressure until we see an end to this inhumane practice of separating children from their families at the borders.
Últimas palabras, necesitamos seguir poniendo pressure en nuestros representantes del Congreso, necesitamos seguir demandando que las familias sean reunificadas.
And they, since we organized this news conference, we've heard word that the DHS is claiming that they're going to reunify the families, but the plan is secret and they can't tell us what it is. And the, you know, the track record of this administration is such that you really can't believe anything you hear, and maybe not even believe the things you see.
Y desde haber empezado esta esta congregación de las noticias, han avisado del Departamento de Homeland Security que ellos planean reunificar las familias, pero con la consistencia de la administración nunca han sido transparentes, y lo que dijeron es que el plan de forma cómo van a reunificar va a tener que ser en secreto, y eso no nos va a satisfacer y no podemos quedarnos con esa clase de respuesta.
And finally, we'll hear a few words from CARES Government Affairs Director Robert McCaw on what you should do and can do to help influence public officials on this important issue.
Hi, my name is Robert McCaw, MCCAW. I'm the CARE National Government Affairs Director. I just want to first state that earlier today, I did speak with the Youth for Tomorrow representative. They told me that there may be a mother with their child or mothers with their children here, but they would not confirm or deny whether the mothers are allowed to leave this facility. They wouldn't confirm or deny what is the current status of the fathers of these children. They would not confirm nor deny where these families were picked up from, how long they have been here. These are serious questions that need to be answered, because otherwise these mothers and children are being held against their will.
Hoy antes hablamos con personas adentro de la organización de Youth for Tomorrow, y ellos dijeron que sí habían madres con hijos aquí, pero nunca aclararon si los padres pueden salir o los hijos, o nunca dieron respuestas, y no negaron ni aprobaron nuestras preguntas.
And so what we can do next, as a nation, we have to continue this pressure. There's no transparency about these children at this facility or the other facilities. We need to keep the pressure up. While the president has signed an executive order that says they'll no longer separate these families, there's 2,300 families that are currently separated, and they have to hear from us, these members of Congress. They need to keep on putting the pressure on the president, and they need to know that these families must be reunited.
Y ya que el presidente ha firmado una orden ejecutiva, nosotros como gente de esta nación necesitamos poner pressure para que puedan reunificar a las familias.
Thank you. And my son has something to say.
Free the babies.
Que liberen a los bebés.
What did he say?
Free the babies.
All right, well, thank you. And you can go to www.cair.com. We have an action alert on our site through which you can contact your elected representatives and urge them to help reunify these families that have been taken apart for no reason, at the border, and through an executive action by the Trump administration. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum.